me through how you see the ability or the influence of the UAE when it comes to bringing, how would you say, worrying about tensions, but bringing the tone down. How important is it that women be involved in government in order to do that?
Well, good morning, Hadley. Good morning, Dan. Thanks so much for having me here. And first of all, that's a big question before my second cup of coffee, but I'll do my best. So the UAE sees women's empowerment as part of its foreign policy posture, as well as part of its national security strategy. It's not only a human rights issue or an economic empowerment issue, but it's also a political issue, not just in the region, but around the world. I think that's the first premise, and that's part of the reason the Dubai Women Establishment is leading on this global forum that has brought some of the leading thinkers, practitioners, policymakers, and peacemakers from around the world, primarily women, to share best practice and share experience about how we go about the business of diplomacy and de-escalation, as well as economic empowerment, lifting up hundreds of millions out of poverty. I think that's a really key part of what we are doing here in Dubai, and it's due to the fantastic leadership in our country, of course, that this is such an essential part of our foreign policy posture. To the second part of your question, I think it's clear for us as the UAE, where we sit at the United Nations, where 193 countries sit and debate these peace and security issues around the day, that women form part of the peace and security continuum, which is why, for example, the UAE is an avid supporter of the Women, Peace and Security Resolution 1325 that mandates the involvement of women in the peace and security architecture around the world in conflict. Today, unfortunately, less than 10% of women are sitting at the peacemaking table or are mediators or negotiators in peace solutions. And I think you see that that correlates directly to the length of how long peace agreements last. So, for example, they would last 35 years or longer if women are around the table. They are now lasting 5 years or less because women are not consistently around the table.
So this is a security imperative, not just for the UAE, but globally.
Absolutely. It's a security imperative today. Not only is it the right thing to do, so it's a moral imperative, but it's the smart thing to do in terms of your foreign policy, to lift women up, empower women, not just in our part of the world, but around the world, to be part of that peace and security global architecture. I'll give you an example of how we're doing that, a real example. Peacekeepers at the UN, you recognize them as blue helmets in some of the toughest conflict zones in the world. What was noticed that not enough women were coming up through the pipeline of peace and security around the world in these conflict areas. So the UAE, through its military training academy in Abu Dhabi, is now training a new cohort of peace and security, peacekeeping troops, police, judiciary, to come up and be part of that peace and security architecture. We trained over 140 last year. The cohort was 140. This year it's over 181, and not just from the Middle East region, but also from Asia and Africa. So that's really part of our global contribution to women, peace and security and that agenda.
When you think about this within the context of what's happening specifically in this region, we're talking about that peace plan that's been proposed by the president. When you looked at what was happening, His Excellency Yusuf Atteba was in the room at the White House, Benjamin Netanyahu, the president. Do you think that if there was a woman involved directly at the top, there could potentially be a deal? Is that what's lacking in this conversation?
Well, that's a very binary question between women being there and not being there. But I think it's clear.
Well, it speaks directly to your point, which is important in terms of dialing down the tensions in the region, that women be involved. And at this point, they aren't involved at the very top in this conversation.
In the UAE, women are involved at the very top. We're over a third of our cabinet are women. 50% of our parliament are women. Women ministers, women leading in stem cell research, women leading in space, and putting our first astronaut into space was primarily something that women were part of. So 70% of our university graduates are women. If you don't take from that pipeline and contribute to your economy and your society, clearly that society isn't going to flourish. That includes regional peace and security. So I'm the UAE's first ambassador to the United Nations who is a woman. But I am one of many countries who also have an ambassador at the United Nations who is a woman, and it's their first time, and they come from Western countries. We're now at about 50, so we're nowhere near parity. But today I brought with me 9 women ambassadors from the United Nations to see what we're doing from across the regions here in Dubai as a potential example of trying to accelerate that change for women's empowerment. And that includes in regional peace and security issues. Mm-hmm.